believe this is about enchantment. Dimitri is trying to steal my company. Do you understand that? My whole life hinges on what you found out.
Eric, it is not my problem.
All right, I understand that you hate me. So beat me, kick me, do whatever it is you have to do. But please don't let me lose the one thing that I have in my life. Come on, Jack, you're not that serious.
How handy it is to be husband and wife.
Oh, Nat, who would do a thing like that?
I'll go get Jeremy.
No. I don't want anyone to know.
You could be in danger.
No, I will not have this evening ruined for Dimitri.
Natalie?
Do not come in here!
What is it? What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. I'm just sewing off my wedding dress, and I don't want you to see it.
You sounded upset.
Natalie, tell him. He's got to know.
Natalie?
Just a minute! Darling, sorry, I'm just overreacting to a silly superstition.
Oh, of course. Natalie, nothing could bring us bad luck.
I know I'm being silly. We're so close to our wedding day, I don't want to take any chances.
Are you sure that that's all it was?
Mm-hmm. I'm fine, really. Why aren't you going back to our guests? I'll be down in a minute.
Well, don't be too long. I miss you.
Oh, I won't.
You may not agree with the tactics I used to get you to marry me.
Force you to marry me, you mean.
But I love you, Erica, and I would never humiliate you the way Jackson did just now.
No, you'd find a much more painful, hurtful way to do that.
I mean it. You've got to stay away from Jackson Montgomery. He's not any good for you. He's not to be trusted.
You don't run my life, Adam.
Yes, I'm just like my daughter now. Do you want to go on being hurt?
I hurt him.
You hurt him? Are you joking? That man has a hide like a rhinoceros and a brain to match. He has no idea how precious you are.
You do?
Yes, I most certainly do. You outshine every woman in this world.
Yes, I do. But I'm sure that tarnish will fade the minute that Dimitri Marek really takes over enchantment and tosses me out of my keister.
Well, then, I won't let him do that. You and I will outsmart that slithering predator and live happily ever after.
Listen to me, Adam. If you would really like to show how much you love me, if you would really like to help, why don't you stop laughing and get back over there and find out what Jack and Brooke have on Dimitri Marek from Vienna? So far, you have found zilch.
Hi. May I?
Certainly.
Thank you. They do look like fellow conspirators, don't
they? Yes, they do, and I'm sure that's the reason you're here together.
I am alive again.
Oh, and I am where I belong.
Seen Helga at all, what?
I was just wondering.
Well, don't worry. Knowing Helga, she's probably taking care of everything.
It is a lovely place.
It's absolutely perfect. Just as we'd hoped. Did your friends approve of your wedding dress?
Oh, they thought it was unique.
I can't wait to see you with it. If there are any problems, Helga's an excellent seamstress. She'll be able to help you with alterations.
She already has.
Well?
Brooke told me everything.
Everything?
The whole story.
Oh, Barry.
We're staying together.
Do you suppose we'll ever run out of things to say?
Never. There are a million ways to say I love you.
I just don't want you to be hurt.
Hurt?
If you keep interrogating everybody about Vienna, you will.
I'm not afraid of you, Jude.
It's not what I mean.
Will you just tell me what that's?
You've suffered enough at Jack's hands already. Don't make me add to it. Just leave the Vienna trip alone.
Oh, don't tell me that you're still harping on this Jack and Brooke going to Vienna because it was a romance.
No, I didn't say that.
Well, if Brooke did, it was just a stupid, malicious lie intended to hurt me, and it is not working. Because believe me, there is nothing going on between Brooke and Jack. I would certainly know if there were.
Of course you would, my darling. Of course you would.
Don't they?
Nat is covering so well.
I hope we're wrong.
Me too, Sarah, but gosh, her dress slashed like that. It's crazy.
I know. All we can do is keep our eye on her.
It was just a clock.
I know. I'm sorry. I'm just jumping. I'll be glad when this party is over and Natalie is safe and sound.
Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. Everything is fine. Now, there is no reason for concern. Most likely, the ice storm has caused a power failure, but the festivities will continue with the help of candlelight.
It's the ghost again. I know it is.
We're not going to go through that again, are we?
I know you don't believe me, but she's here.
Timmy, there are no ghosts.
Then how come no one's allowed on the third floor on account that that's worse?
Timmy, what'd you promise Trevor? You'd go easy on the ghost stuff, right?
Yeah. Mom's got enough to deal with.
Exactly. Come on, it's a party. Let's have fun. Come on.
Okay, sure.
Hey,
later.
Be cool. Behave yourself.
All right, then.
Timmy, hi.
Hi.
Do you remember me? I'm Erica Kane.
Sure. You look really great when you do.
Well, thank you very much. You look really terrific, too.
Thanks. I hate all this stuff, except for my tie. Trevor gave it to me.
He did? Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah.
I like that. You know something? You and I haven't had any chance to talk to you. How about now? Could we talk now?
Sure. What do you want to talk about?
It was a ghost for sure.
Well, of course it was. My goodness, I would think that a spooky house like this would have at least one ghost.
But you're the only one who believes me.
Well, I think that most people are just afraid to believe in ghosts.
This one is mean, though. She's just sad.
Oh, really? Well, that's too bad. Timmy, you know, I'd really love to see her. How do I get up to the third floor?
No one's allowed up there.
Well, it could be just our little secret, that's all. And maybe I could cheer her up.
Well, go to the stairs in the living room and go up and keep going. It's the last door on the left.
Oh, great. Okay, now, Timmy, don't tell him.
Don't worry, I will. Thanks.
What little scheme are you cooking up now?
Oh. Adam, I am going to see the ghost of Wildwind.
What?
Yes, I am. Timmy told me he saw a ghost all dressed in white.
Timmy saw a ghost, and now you're going to see it.
Absolutely, I am. Adam, this ghost could be the skeleton rattling around in Dimitri Merrick's house.
Erica, you can't be serious.
Of course I'm serious. Timmy said he heard it coming.
Her?
Her. I'm going to find her, Adam. Her. And who knows, this just may turn out to be a surprise party.
Ghost hunting, Erica? This is ridiculous.
Adam, if someone is hiding up there, I want to know who and why.
So you can...
Hold it over Dimitri Merritt as a threat if he doesn't back off the takeover promise.
This is crazy.
Crazy? Adam, no one is allowed up on the third floor. Now, Timmy told me that he heard someone crying up there. Ghosts don't cry.
No, because ghosts don't exist.
Right. Which would lead one to believe that there is a flesh and blood person up there. Now, I am going up there, and I'm going to find out exactly who or what no one is allowed to see.
You're not chasing rainbows, you're chasing ghosts.
And I always get exactly what I want, don't I? Isn't that one of the things that you admire about me most?
That and your adorable little...
Shut up, Adam. Don't even think about it. Now, if you really love me the way you say you do, and you will help me, and you will keep your mouth shut and your eyes on Dimitri and me, and do not let anyone come.
Your searchlight, madame.
See? You're not all bad.
Be careful. I better have.
You even look more beautiful in candlelight.
Well, then we must do this more often.
That can be arranged.
Oh.